Hello, today we are going to talk about art, systematic, and cybernetics. To begin with, let's talk about what does the word cybernetics means. The term itself began its rise to popularity in 1947. An American mathematician named Norbert Wiener defines cybernetics as a scientific method that using probability theory to control the transmission of information. It aims at controlling and automating the behavior of mechanical and also the biological systems. Maybe we can take a look at the etymology. Cybernetics comes from a Greek word meaning the art of steering. It is about having a goal and taking action to achieve that goal. In a simple way to explain it, it is similar to a boat with an intelligent system. It keeps trying, acting, seeing, and changing the differences by crossing the winds, the broads, or the oceans. It has the potential to automatically have self-correction and bring you to the goal. While in the process of getting to the goal, it involves an important keyword, the feedback loop. Once there is input, the information like the wind, it will process to see, analyze, and think. Then, maybe have some new information. It will therefore process again and finally have an output, the correct way to go to the goal. So, we can say that information is the base of cybernetics. The cybernetics use feedback loop to control the flow of information. The behavior of humans and machines can therefore be automated and controlled. After having a clear concept about the words, let's talk about the convergence and complementarities between cybernetics and art. It could basically divide into four parts. First, interaction with viewers. Second, putting visual form into actual motion. Third, the concept of feedback. And lastly, focus on temporality. First of all, the interaction with viewer. Roy Ascott, a British artist, states, "Art was located in an interactive system rather than residing in a material object." While Bernhard Jack, an American writer, said, "The specific function of modern didactic art has been to show that art does not reside in material entities, but in relations between people and the components of their environment." The term interaction is used to express the idea of multiple levels of interrelations among artists, artwork, and audience. Later on, it is refined that art as a cybernetic system comprised of a network of feedback loops. As we said, a feedback loop is the cycle of input, process, output. It requires the flow of information, while the potential of an artwork is depend on the interaction, the exchange of information between the artist, the viewer, and the object. Consequently, art is not just an interactive system, but also a cybernetic system. Here is an example from Roy Ascott, Change Paintings. As viewers altered the work by sliding the panels along the horizontal axis, the composition of the interactive conjunctions changed. Therefore, the appearance of the cybernetic encouraged the interaction and enlarged the potential of an artwork. Second, it is about putting facial form into actual motion. Instead of Asgard, many 20th century artists actually does not familiar with the concept of cybernetics, but still experience with the process, kinetic, interactivity, audience participation, duration, and environment. They are relying primarily on the aesthetics tendency to explain their works. For instance, the bicycle wheel from The Shop, which consisting of a bicycle fork with Fern's wheel mounted upside down on a wooden stool. It made motion an intrinsic quality of the art object, further emphasizing the aspect of time. It results that the outcome is not just aesthetics, but from science to art. Of course, in the process of experimenting between art and technology, there were a certain numbers of failed artwork. For example, the cybernetic serendipity by Jasia Weikart. It is an exhibition of cybernetics art. Includes computer printout of musical analyze, computer design choreography, and computer generate text and poem. Unfortunately, because of the limited budget and poor packing and handling while shipping, part of the content was destroyed. Despite the salvage from several engineers, the artist disowned his work and thus become a failed artwork. Here's a question from this assumption. Are this kind of art really a failure? In my point of view, these are similar to experimental art that experiments with anything and everything, with raw matter or time, relationships among people, things, and tendency. The work, I, Dreaming, is an experimental short film such that the film features a soundtrack of Stephen Foster's songs composed by Joe and sets images to the music. The soundtrack often jumps from one musical phase or a song to another. It brings audience a new aspect of cinema. Similarly, although Jasia's work faces lots of failure, it is still an artwork. At least, it experiments with the potential of an artwork under a limited budget and poor shipping. So, instead of a failed art, it is an experimental art to me. Thirdly, it's about the concept of feedback. Cybernetics encourage the aesthetic strategy of engaging the audience more directly in a work. They use feedback of information to express an independent manifestation. For instance, the 4 minutes 33 seconds by John. There is a whole music group sitting in the concert hall, but having no notes. The piece actually involves the ambient sound of the environment, including listeners' breathing or any other noise. The work integrates the audience into the information, use feedback to generate art. The above 3 points actually implies an important part, which is the temporality. Scholars from biography and philosophy both claim that linking past, present, and future is dissolving the appearance of categorical time and providing a unified experience of the continuous change. As a result, the speed of response of audience and environment is critical for work. Okay, now let's talk about the influence of cybernetics and systematics. It definitely helps us understand more. Under the feedback loop, we share more and more, and therefore understand more about the world. Like how the world works, including the chemical, physical, biological, and social world. It recognizes the world and finds a way to improve it. It is a powerful language for looking the world. It also improves ourselves. In the process of steering our goal, it captures the things that not yet done. For instance, one will take out the word that does not make sense and rethink it until it makes sense. It is somehow a conversation in one's brain. It forms one's actions. So, cybernetic systems improve you too through this conversation. It discovers the mystery of human thinking and communication. Of course, the conversation is not only about oneself, but also the others. The others listen, think, question, and therefore help you make sense of what you mean. The two-way conversation could apply in the art pedagogy. Cybernetics offer a clear model for reconceptualizing arts and education. That arts education should be a behavioral system of feedback and control. A common example is forming groups of students. Now, here is a group of 6 students. They are asked to complete a goal. At first, there will be preconceptions about others' personalities, strengths, and weaknesses. But in order to achieve the goal, they will of necessary independent and highly conscious of each other's capabilities and limitations. This behavioral interaction is a kind of controlled exchange of information that makes us observe more and communicate more, so that it enhances human creativity, enables interaction, and leads to a better me. However, I do have a question from this assumption. Does it really improve ourselves? In the previous class, we discussed something about the volatilization. According to Burnett, technology is always a formicon. Like the GPS, it helps you find a road, but also makes you lose the ability to read a map. Similarly, the feedback loop encourages a conversation, receive more feedback, but also some negative feedback. Like the group example above, if one of the students breaks the conversation, the loop ends, and no more communication, understanding between them. Therefore, I do agree that the cybernetics provide a conversation, but the output for the feedback loop is a positive one or negative one is not yet known. In conclusion, the systemic cybernetics covers a wide variety of aspects, including social, individual, education, and cultural. It is hoped that the video can help you understanding more about it. Thanks for your attention.